Did you ever play Club Penguin, and when you walked into a room, there were suddenly hundreds of penguins in the exact same color, in the exact same outfit, making the exact same emote in an organized formation? Or maybe it wasn't just one group of penguins doing that, but two? Well, I'm here to explain what that's all about, because I was in one of those groups. These are known as Club Penguin Armies. But first, let me tell you what Club Penguin means to me. Club Penguin was the first online experience I ever had. Before, I just assumed the internet was used for email and researching facts for school or work, as well as some flash games here and there. But one sleepover at my best friend's house, I saw him playing a game with penguins, and I was like, wait, is that another person on another computer? And when he said yes, I thought that was the coolest thing ever, and I wanted to give it a try. Anyway, back to the armies. So what is a Club Penguin army? It's a group of Club Penguin players who battle other groups of Club Penguin players. How do Club Penguin armies fight each other? Well, since in Club Penguin you can't actually fight, the way it works is a bit odd. Since we can't fight other players, armies battle based on comparing maximum size, average size, and well-executed tactics. Tactics are included but not limited to line formations, shape formations, emoting simultaneously, chanting a phrase simultaneously, room changing, and charging while emoting slash chanting. At the end of an event, which is usually 30 minutes, the most organized army wins. Usually this is self-proclaimed by the army leader, forfeited by the opposing team, or decided by a judge if it's a tournament. Tournaments are usually hosted by an army hub site, which I'll elaborate more on later. How do armies host events? Back in the original Club Penguin days, every army would have a WordPress site where the admins would post the next event, as well as other news going on within the army. Nowadays, it's done on the army's Discord servers. Where do armies meet up to do tactics? We used to use a chat site known as zat.com, but now everyone uses Discord. And tactics would be executed by counting down from 3, followed by the key commands for the emotes, or hit enter for the phrase you're about to say. What is an army hub site? These sites are used to find every known Club Penguin army, as well as read news going on within the armies. As I said before, sometimes these hub sites would host a tournament for all the armies to participate in, and at the end you would get a trophy and a interview with the leader of the hub site. How many Club Penguin armies are there? Honestly, countless. Heck, you could create your own Club Penguin army if you wanted to, it doesn't have to be known by the hub sites. Some of the most famous ones from the original Club Penguin were the Army of Club Penguin, or ACP, the Ice Warriors, the Rebel Penguin Federation, or RPF, SWAT, the Underground Mafia Army, or UMA, the Light Troops, the Waytex Warriors, the Shadow Troops, Army Republic, Water Vikings, the Ninjas, and last, but definitely not least, the army I was in, the Nachos. ACP was the most popular army, but Nachos were their arch rivals. Anytime there was a Nachos versus ACP war, it was as classic as Marvel versus DC. I think the Nachos even started this trend that happened in CP armies where people would start their own armies and name it after a food. There was eventually a Tacos, Nuggets, Brownies, and even a Takis army. The only army I can remember that was a food army that became just as popular as the Nachos were the Doritos of Club Penguin, and they became our rivals for a long time as well as ACP. Now, why did I join the Nachos? Well, it was mainly because I wanted to meet the leader at the time who made funny Club Penguin videos on YouTube. I think he even got a little popular on Club Penguin. He had a link to the Nachos website and his channel, and that pretty much is how I came across the entire army community. Everyone there was cool. For a while, Nachos was known as one of the more edgy armies because most army chats didn't allow swearing, but we did. We even had a specific time at night where people could get as adult content as they wanted. I never participated in that. I usually left when that happened. Oh yeah, I did eventually meet the person I wanted to meet. When I first talked to him, I always saw him as this big celebrity and I'd be nervous talking to him, but I eventually outgrew that, and now whenever I see him, if we talk, it's just me talking to another buddy of mine. If I'm being perfectly honest, most armies are pretty chill. Everyone is friendly or obsessed with the next event, but once in a while there'd be a crazy leader who would take the game way too seriously. Some would even threaten their own comrades to log on, or else they'd be demoted, fired, banned, or even hacked. This didn't happen in every army, and it especially never happened in the Nachos. It was just a rare thing that would happen, and usually if it did happen, the other mods and admins would overthrow the abusive leader. These people were where I learned what the words doxing and DDoSing was, because, I kid you not, people would dox and DDoS each other over losing a battle in Club Penguin. One of the hardest things to do in Club Penguin Armies was recruit more people into our group. This got even harder during the later years of Club Penguin because Club Penguin didn't allow users to tell people to go to another website, which is a good rule, of course, but there were times where armies weren't doing so well. As people got older, everyone started to leave due to real-life responsibilities, or they simply got tired of Club Penguin armies. Another big problem was people started using autotypers for recruiting, which would loop all day. This eventually got the mods of Club Penguin to filter out army-related words and even banning people for being in an army or just wearing the uniform. Even the word nacho got filtered. Thankfully, most armies were able to keep going through these hard times, and now there are Club Penguin private servers that are more accepting to armies. There was one thing I really didn't like about Club Penguin armies, and that is when we eventually started doing treaties. It was an agreement not to battle a certain army or raid their server. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, armies pretended certain servers were their territory, and other armies weren't allowed to even be on any of them unless during a war. Anyway, these treaties would basically say, we won't battle you or log on to your server for another 6 to 8 months, which in my opinion kind of defeats the whole purpose of an army game, made up or not. What I love about Club Penguin armies is, while to some this entire concept may be silly and complicated, and there are people who take the game way too seriously, it still brought a bunch of people together. I've made countless friends who I still keep in touch with to this day, and anyone else in this community usually says the same thing. Most of the armies I mentioned, including the Nachos, are now disbanded because of the original Club Penguin shutdown, but we've all made some cherished memories throughout the years. Anyway, if you want to see for yourself what the Club Penguin army community is like, there's a link in the description to the main hub site where you can see all the different armies that are currently active, or you could even make your own army if you want to. Hey everyone, I hope you liked this video. If you did, I hope you'll stick around to see more in the future. So, one time in the Nacho chat, everyone was talking about Pokemon, and someone mentioned how Bidoof sounds like a word that would be used as an insult. So for the next 2 days or so, everyone kept calling each other a Bidoof whenever they wanted to make fun of someone. So if you dislike this video, you're a massive Bidoof. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't do microtransactions.